Governor DeWitt Clinton of New York. His dream changed America's destiny, for he was the father of the Erie Canal, the golden gateway to the West, more than a century ago. Opened in 1825, the Erie Canal was the first empire builder in our history. It was the only water highway through the long Appalachian mountain chain. Supplying a route for the settlers to go west, it gave them a means for shipping their goods back east. Overnight, the canal opened the east to the west and the west to the east. In New York State, towns sprang up all along the 500-mile route. Buffalo and Albany, the terminal cities, grew rapidly. And New York City became the greatest port city in the United States and eventually the world. Clinton's folly, the critics called the inland waterway. How wrong they were. The Erie Canal became the thread that wove a far-flung nation into a unified America. An abandoned ditch, choked with debris. This is a remnant, one of the original canal locks. 40 feet wide and 4 feet deep along most of the way, the canal seems pitifully small by modern standards, but in its day it was a monumental achievement. There were no roads to haul supplies. Its builders had no previous engineering experience and only the crudest of tools. The men cut through solid rock by hand and black powder, building 82 locks to overcome a difference of 571 feet between the water level of the Hudson River and Lake Erie. It took 8 years to complete. It would remain in use some 80 years. The task of replacing the old canal with a new waterway began in 1905 and continued for 13 years. The modern barge canal follows the picturesque pioneer route along part of its journey across New York State. Lock 2 at the eastern end of the new canal dramatizes the change from 19th to 20th century barge travel. Operated by electricity, each of the 57 locks can raise or lower a vessel in 20 minutes. The giant steel gates can be opened in 30 seconds. There is room for any vessel up to 300 feet in length. The depth of the waterway has been lowered from 4 to 12 feet. Now barges carrying up to 1,000 tons of cargo can make the canal voyage. Pushed snugly into Lock 2 at Waterford, this barge will be raised 33.5 feet at the start of its westward passage to Buffalo. Grain, chemicals, sugar, pig iron, heavy machinery, and fertilizers are the leading cargo shipments. As the rear gate shuts to enclose the barge within the lock, sluice gates open to pour water into the huge concrete chamber. The vessel rises swiftly and easily as if pushed upward by a powerful lift. In a few seconds, it is at the top of the lock. Ahead stretches a broad, fresh level of water, a highway that, since the Erie's opening, has been the main track of America's commercial development. The junction of the Hudson and Mohawk rivers seen below made possible the conquest of the Allegheny Divide. The original canal utilized the Mohawk Valley, the middle link between the Great Lakes and the Hudson. Lock 17 at Little Falls has a lift of 40.5 feet, the highest in the system. Little Falls is typical of the cities that sprang up with the canal's completion and became busy centers of trade. In the 20 years after the Erie's opening, New York's population almost doubled. The Empire State had been born. The swirling currents of history have failed to diminish the commercial importance of the canal. Hundreds of ships use it every year, traveling upwards of 2 million miles with cargo loads. Each lock is 328 feet in length, 45 feet in width, and up to 50 feet in height. With all its branches, the Erie Canal is 9 times longer than the Panama Canal. In one stretch of 2 miles, the waterway drops 169 feet through 5 locks. This is the most remarkable flight of locks in the world. But the transformation along the banks of the Erie was even more spectacular. Lockport was and still is one of the important ports on the canal. 320 miles from the eastern end of the Erie, it owes its life to the pioneers who believed in Clinton's folly. The doubters were many. Even Thomas Jefferson had said, "To talk of making a canal 350 miles through a wilderness is little short of madness in this day." Today's vessel riding smoothly through the step-up at Lockport symbolizes the dreams that became deeds to make America great. A century ago, the cry, "Low Bridge," rang out on wooden canal boats as settlers dodged under old spans on their way west. The spirit of adventure that drove them on still rides the Erie Canal. No other waterway in America did what the Erie did. It was from the beginning a golden cord and bond in our national growth. At both ends, east and midwest, and in the middle, it rubbed Aladdin's lamp. America awoke, catching for the first time a sweeping look at its limitless future.
This film is one of a series on current affairs, presented as a public service by the Massachusetts Mutual Life Insurance Company, now in its second century of service.